We're prepared. We're totally prepared. And likewise, we're prepared to attack if we have to. If you look at what's going on, ours was an attack based on what they did. We weren't the first one out. He killed an American. Now two people are dead from the same attack, and some people very badly wounded. And that was one of his smaller endeavors. You look over his past. His past, he's been called a monster, and he was a monster. And he's no longer a monster. He's dead. And that's a good thing for a lot of countries. And he was planning a very big attack and a very bad attack for us and other people. And we stopped him. And I don't think anybody can complain about it. I don't hear too many people other than politicians who are trying to win the presidency. Those are the ones that are complaining. But I don't hear anybody else complaining. They weren't there to discuss a vacation. They weren't there to go to a nice resort someplace in Baghdad. They were there to discuss bad business. And we saved a lot of lives by terminating his life. A lot of lives are saved. They were planning something, and you're going to be hearing about it, or at least various people in Congress are going to be hearing about it tomorrow. We had tremendous information. We've been following him for a long time, and we followed his path for those 3 days. And they were not good stops. We didn't like where he was stopping. They were not good stops. We saved a lot of lives. Mike?
We had deep intelligence indicating there was active plotting that put American lives at risk. And I'm confident, I think the president's confident, too, that the actions that the president took saved American lives, saved lives of Iraqi Muslims as well. It was the right thing to do, and our Department of Defense did an excellent job executing the mission.